Question: why is the EV industry moving from 400 volt to 800 volt architecture? Welcome to my channel, Rudy Romo here. In this video, I will first share portions of articles from Sarah Lee Jones of Tesla North and Maria Merano of Teslarati breaking the news that the first Tesla V4 Supercharger in the US has gone live in Sparks, Nevada. In the second part of the video, I will outline the differences between a V3 and a V4 Supercharger, as well as the advantages of the V4 units using the 800 volt architecture. The Tesla charging team just announced the opening of the first V4 Superchargers in the United States. The new Tesla V4 Superchargers are located in Sparks, Nevada. Tesla's V4 Superchargers will be instrumental in the rollout of the Cybertruck. One of Tesla's all-electric pickup trucks was recently spotted charging at a V4 Supercharger stall. Tesla Cybertruck deliveries start next month. While maintaining the same 250 kilowatt output as the V3 Superchargers, the new V4 version features longer cables, measuring nearly 9.5 feet, compared to the 6.5 feet cables of the V3 model. The V4 Superchargers were initially introduced in Europe. They also come with a new pedestal design. Quote, "We opened our first V4 Supercharger location in Harderwijk, the Netherlands, in March 2023, and we will open more V4 sites in the second half of this year. All V4 Superchargers are equipped with a longer cable, providing easy access for all EVs. V4 currently supports peak rates of up to 250 kilowatt per vehicle and is future-proof to allow for updates and new features," unquote, says Tesla. This marks a significant upgrade in the company's charging infrastructure, offering more convenience to Tesla vehicle owners. The longer cables will also accommodate non-Tesla EVs if magic docks are available. The V4 Supercharger stalls that recently opened in Nevada will be near Tesla's Gigafactory in Sparks. The V4 Supercharger stalls were added to the V3 station near Tesla's Gigafactory. The V4 Superchargers have adapters so non-Tesla vehicles could use them. Earlier this month, Tesla installed the first V4 Supercharger in Asia. It's on Hong Kong Island at Lee Guard 1 in Causeway Bay. Tesla Superchargers can cost from $3.05 to $4.05 in Hong Kong dollars, which is about 39 cents to 52 cents in USD per kilowatt hour between 4 a.m. and 12 midnight. Meanwhile, in Europe, the European Union granted Tesla funding of about 149 million euros to install and expand its supercharger network in the continent. Tesla plans to use the funds to install or upgrade more than 7,000 superchargers to V4 stalls. Tesla's V4 Superchargers have been spotted across a few locations in the U.S. Earlier this month, V4 Superchargers were spotted in a suburb outside Atlanta, Georgia. The Tesla station was still under construction and surrounded by a chain-link fence. Besides the one in Georgia, 8 V4 Supercharger stalls were spotted in Wilsonville, Oregon. A few V4 Superchargers were also spotted in Prattville, Alabama. Now let's compare the two different systems and the advantages of 800 volt architecture over 400 volt on EV superchargers. Full disclosure, the specific numbers and percentages cited in this video are based on estimates from various sources, including automakers, charging companies, and industry experts. I welcome your comments on this subject. 800 volt architecture is the next generation of electric vehicle charging technology. It offers a number of advantages over the current 400 volt architecture, including faster charging. 800 volt systems can support charging rates of up to 350 kilowatts compared to 250 kilowatt for 400 volt systems. This means that EV owners can charge their vehicles up to 40% faster with 800 volt systems. Smaller and lighter cables. 800 volt systems can use cables that are up to 50% smaller and lighter than cables used in 400 volt systems. This can reduce the weight of the vehicle and make it more energy efficient. Reduce losses. 800 volt systems have losses that are up to 10% lower than losses in 400 volt systems. This means that more of the energy from the charger can be used to charge the EV's battery. Increase range. The reduced losses in 800-volt systems can lead to an increase of range of up to 5%. Improved performance. 800-volt systems can support higher power levels than 400-volt systems. This can lead to improvements in acceleration and top speed of up to 10%. So which companies and EV models are using the 800-volt architecture? A number of automakers are developing and producing EVs with 800-volt architecture. These include Tesla with a Cybertruck and the Semi, Porsche with a Taycan, as well as Audi, Hyundai, Kia, Genesis, Mercedes-Benz, BMW, Volvo, Rivian, and Lucid. It is expected that more automakers will begin offering EVs with 800-volt architecture in the coming years. As the technology becomes more widespread, the cost of 800-volt charging infrastructure is expected to come down, making it more accessible to EV owners. Conclusion: 800-volt architecture offers a number of significant advantages over 400-volt architecture, including faster charging, smaller and lighter cables, reduced losses, increased range, and improved performance. As more automakers begin offering EVs with 800-volt architecture and the cost of 800-volt charging infrastructure comes down, we can expect to see this technology become more widespread in the coming years. And thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button, share, and subscribe so that YouTube algorithms will get it to more people. If you disagree with any of the points made, or if you have any suggestions on how to improve future videos, please comment below. The material and thoughts shared here are based on my own personal research and factual to the best of my knowledge. Please do your own research.